Hello, dear Steamians, YouTubers, members of Uptrend, and all beautiful and creative blockchain people. That's me again at CryptoSpa, and this is my next cryptocurrency market overview. But of course, I'm wearing my SteamFest 4 t-shirt from Bangkok, Thailand, Bangkok. So it was SteamFest was an amazing event. Once again, I want to say that I'm planning on visiting the next SteamFest. SteamFest number 5, but let's have a look at the prices of the major cryptocurrencies according to the beautiful site of CoinGecko. And of course, follow CoinGecko because they are on Steam blockchain as well, and they had a beautiful presentation at SteamFest. So, according to the site of CoinGecko, Bitcoin is trading at the level of $8,418. Ethereum is trading at the level of $181. XRP is trading at the level of 25 cents, 0.8533. So, as we see, most of the charts of the major cryptocurrencies have been in the red zone for the last 7 hours. So their prices have been under pressure. And today is Monday. Usually on Mondays, I comment on or I analyze the price of Bitcoin. But since I did it on Saturday, let's have another kind of cryptocurrency market overview. Today, I just want to comment on some interesting news and etc. But I just want to say that it seems that the cryptocurrency market will be in a kind of, let's say, declining phase, or the prices will be under pressure probably in the next few weeks as well, in my view. So I'm a little bit, let's say, neutral to more skeptic to the prices of the major cryptocurrencies about the near future. I'm not that bullish, and I have explained this many, many times. That's why let's move today to some interesting news. And what I want to say is, I found a very interesting tweet with news and information in the Twitter account of CZ from Binance. So we know that he's the main person behind the biggest crypto exchange in the world, Binance. And he wrote this tweet: crypto gives rise to new business models that don't involve selling ads or user data. Selling ads or user data. The choice is yours. And the tweet is about the Brave browser. So this is the Brave browser, and I've been using it for almost 1 year, and I'm really very, very, very happy with Brave browser. In addition, you can get some rewards in BAT tokens. But what I want to mention relating to this tweet is that a new privacy first browser can replace Chrome on all your devices. So fellas, if you really value privacy and you want to get, let's say, decentralized, you can download this Brave browser. Most of the cryptocurrency enthusiasts use it. You can download it even on your phone. I use it on my phone as well. And what I want to say is, I think that Brave has a great potential. And if we have a look at the price of the BAT token, so this is the native token of Brave ecosystem, BAT has been doing quite well. For the last 7 days, we see that its price has been slowly, slowly increasing. Actually, it has increased so far by 7.3%. So this is the BAT token, basic attention token. And we see that BAT is in top 30. So once again, you can have a look at brave.com, download the browser and start using it if you find it useful. And of course, it also blocks many ads and etc. So this is a great browser, and I have had a very nice experience with it. Now let's move to some Steam related news. For example, what I want to say is, because I'm still, let's say, under the emotions of SteamFest 4 that took place in Bangkok. It was an amazing event. That's why I'm wearing my SteamFest t-shirt. I check on a daily basis the tag SteamFest, and I am curious what other Steamians upload on a daily basis, or post or write some kind of articles and posts about Bangkok, about the life after Bangkok, about Steam blockchain after SteamFest 4. And what I want to say is, you can find really very nice posts, videos from Bangkok. And actually, for example, people of they upload videos, posts about the life in Bangkok with nice pictures. And what I want to say is that being now at home in my home country, some other people that are not on Steam blockchain and are actually off-chain, they are not a cryptocurrency users, they ask me on a daily basis, hey, what is your experience with Bangkok? Could you recommend some nice places to visit there? Which hotel I should choose, and etc. And what I've been doing, I have been trying to promote Steam blockchain among my friends asking me about Bangkok. And I usually, for example, send some kind of links to videos and posts about Bangkok, about nice places to visit. And I want to say that there is one really great tribe or application or dApp built on the top of Steam blockchain that is called TravelFeed.io. And to be honest, I have never used it, but after visiting Bangkok for Steamfest, I have realized that I have to start to use it because it's a great app for bloggers, for travelers, and I have also personally met the developers and the main persons behind this application, and they are really, really great Steamians, and they are actually here in this pics, in this picture, and they had a presentation at Steamfest as well. And why I'm talking now about TravelFeed.io? Of course, I know that Steamians are beautiful, no doubt, but I just want to say that, let's get back to the point I started, that I'm promoting TravelFeed and travelers blogs from Steamians to my friends, because there are really many, many nice articles, many, many nice posts about different places in the world. And in addition, a new user can subscribe and can sign up with TravelFeed, and he will just by using, as I understand, email account, and TravelFeed will create all the public keys and private keys for the new users. And if a new users want to sign up with Steam, you know that the process is a little bit complicated to people that are off-chain and they don't understand this private keys, public keys, what is it, and etc. TravelFeed is a nice, let's say, application to bring new people to Steam blockchain ecosystem without all these difficulties with the private public keys and etc. That's why, fellas, it seems that TravelFeed.io is a nice application, and probably you may also promote it among your friends that are off-chain and that find it quite difficult to become cryptocurrency user because of all those private public keys and etc. Give them a link to this application. They can have a look at the vlogs and the blogs traveling from travelers. They can decide to write some traveler blogs as well, and they may find it quite easy to join Steam blockchain via TravelFeed.io. So, in addition, I want to say that I will try to write a blog about Bangkok, about my sightseeing, let's say, tour or day in Bangkok, and I will try to use TravelFeed as well. And what I want to say is, because you see that I've been talking a lot about Steamfest and about our beautiful blockchain ecosystem, of course it's because I visited Steamfest and I'm still under the emotions of this beautiful event. I've been recently, to be honest, so looking and searching for other crypto-related events, because I have realized that I like such kind of meetings, such kind of gatherings of creative people from all over the world. And for example, I have found some, let's say, calendars with different dates and events. And have a look at this one. For example, it's on Coindesk.com. And I have checked even the details about some of those conferences, and probably I think I will go in January to Istanbul, Turkey, because it's not far away from here. Of course, I would like, for me, it's much easier to get to some European cities. That's why I cannot easily go to Toronto, Canada, or Montevideo, Uruguay, or Las Vegas. So that's why I've been looking for such kind of places like Paris, like Turkey. And have a look at these conferences. If you find some kind of sites with information about interesting conferences, please send me links because I'm really very curious about it. And who knows, we may meet each other at some of those conferences or meetups. So thank you fellas for watching this video. Today is Monday. I wish you a wonderful week and productive week ahead. Hope to see you in my next video. It was me at CryptoSpark.